Hello dear students, so today we are going to do chapter number 3rd of class 7th. So this is a poem. The name of this chapter is The Flower School. So this poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore, who is the iconic Bengali writer who brought India its first Nobel Prize in literature so far. Through the innocent eyes of school-going child, the poet captures the thrill and excitement of the blossoming of flowers with the onset of rains. So the childlike description of the seasonal appearance and departure of flowers on and from the face of earth touches everyone's heart. Of course, a child's fascination with flowers, her dread of the school and love for her mother are depicted in this short poem with remarkable vividness. That is why this is a small poem has such timeless abiding appeal. So let's start the poem. When storm clouds rumble in the sky and June showers come down, the moist east winds come marching over the heath to blow its bagpipes among the bamboos. So the poet starts the poem by portraying a rainy day season from the cloudy sky and shower coming down in the month of June. So the wind passing through bamboo bowers produces a melodious sound in a large open area. So this is a time period when it is the month of June and it is about to rain. The cloudy season is there. Then crowds of flowers come out of a sudden from nobody knows where and dance upon the grass in the wild glee. Mother, I really think the flowers go to school underground. The meaning of these lines means in the rainy season, the flowers blossom out of nowhere and obviously they dance joyously. So here the poet communes with his mother saying he feels flowers go to school underground where they learn their lessons behind the shut doors. So their master does not let them come out to play. They do their lessons with door shut, and if they want to come out to play before it's time, their master make them stand in a corner. So as I have told earlier, like they are doing, the poet says that they are doing study underground, and if they really want to come out to play or if they really want to enjoy the surrounding, their master make them stand in a corner. Their master let them does not come out to play. When the rain comes, they have their holidays. Branches clash together in the forest and the leaves rustle in the wild wind. The thunder clouds clap their giant hands and the flower children rush out in dresses of pink and yellow and white. So when the rain falls, they have their holidays, and in the rain of the branches of trees in the forest clash, the loud clouds make noise by clapping their big hands. And at the time, the flower children come out dressed with vibrant colors, like they dressed in a pink or they dressed in a yellow or white colors. So the flowers by the time of rain comes out with their own vibrant and bright colors and they bloom there. Do you know, mother, their home is in the sky where the stars are. Haven't you seen how eager they are to get there? Don't you know why they are in such a hurry? Of course, I can guess to whom they raise their arms. They have their mother as I have my own. So in this last stanza, the poet's longing for his deceased mother evokes pathos in the reader's mind. He asks his mother if she knew the flower's home too was in the sky among the stars. He again asks her mother if she had not noticed how eager the flowers always were to get back to their home. So in this line, the last line of the poem brings tear to the eyes of readers. That poet says he knows why the flowers raise their arm to the sky. They do so because their mother is in the sky, exactly like the poet's mother, who also become a star in the sky after her demise. So this was a feeling of a child as he looks at the flowers and their blooming and their growing process. So it was a beautiful and vivid description of budding flowers and their growth in spring. And the children compare flowers to young school children. The speaker seems to be a young child who speaks to a mother figure in the poem, saying that he believes the flowers must go to school underground, as the flowers bursting from the ground and reaching to the sky for their mother. So remind the poet of vibrant school children who have been kept indoors for too long. So this is all about this poem. Thank you.